Yeah.
That's Paramount Plus. It's Paramount Plus. So
Paramount Plus, that's a network here.
It's yeah, but it's over here now as well.
Oh, is it? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So now you can get all the Star Treks.
It's all on the Prime. It's on Prime Video as well. But I'm not subscribed to either of those, so won't be watching it then.
No Star Trek for you, mister.
Nope.
Which is too bad because you're missing out on Lower Decks, which is just...
Well, I think I tried that before, didn't I? When
for well, I mean, for people who like Star Trek, I mean, just all of the... Excuse me.
Blimey, that's why.
All of the... the like little digs back and forth going into the history of Star Trek just makes it such a great and fun show to watch. Plus, it doesn't take itself so seriously.
You know, seriously?
Well, I mean, that's been the problem with the two major sci-fi franchises that are out there right now, Star Wars and Star Trek, is that they take themselves so seriously that they seem to forget that it's fantasy. It's not real, you know, and you've got these fans that are like, well, I want to debate who was the better Kirk, you know, William Shatner or Christopher Pine. It's like, who fucking cares? Who cares? It doesn't matter. Did you like the movies that Chris Pine did? Great. Did you like the movies and the TV show that Shatner did? Wonderful. Does it really matter if Leonard Nimoy or Zachary Quinto plays Spock, or the guy that plays Spock on Brave New Worlds? No, they're characters. It's not real. It's just, oh, there was a
it used to matter to you though, Mike.
Mike, that's me.
It used to happen to you, Guy.
No, Star Trek does matter to me, and I do care about the show. But the minutia that so many people get upset about means nothing to me. I don't care about
you. Mean nothing to me. You mean nothing to me.
If the writing is good,
I smelled a wood of an English wabbit.
That's it, right there, right there. And it doesn't even have to be an English rabbit. It could be a Cornish rabbit. I don't care.
Well,
but. You know, and I do care because, I mean, I still get really upset about Star Trek Discovery because there's so many things wrong with that show. I still get upset about Star Trek Picard because there's so many things wrong with that show. And they play fast and loose with the history that's been established. I don't mind making fun of that history, which is what Star Trek Lower Decks does. But at least acknowledge that it happened and stop trying to fucking change it. Okay, now they're saying the Romulans created the Borg because that was established in Star Trek Picard. And it was like, wait a second. According to Voyager, that was on 20-some freaking years ago, the Borg had been plaguing... The Borg have been plaguing the Delta Quadrant for thousands of years.
Yeah, but hang on a minute. When was the timeline for Voyager as opposed to Picard?
Voyager is going on in the same general time as Next Generation, the original TV show.
So they've got the stories mixed up.
It's not so much that they've got the stories mixed up. It's that they're not. They're not paying attention to what they've already done.
Yeah. Mixing their stories up. Crap.
And it's just. For people who have followed the show for a long time, it's just wrong. I understand that actors get old and can't play those parts anymore. And that other people are going to play them. And that's fine with me if they play them well. And Zachary Quinto, except for how the character was written a couple of times, played Spock very well. Generally played Spock very well. The guy that they have, and I don't know his name, the guy that they have in Brave New Worlds that plays Spock, other than some poorly written dialogue, has played Spock very well. And of the live action shows, Brave New World is my favorite right now because they're paying attention to the canon, even though the genesis of that program came out of a show that didn't pay attention to canon, which was Discovery. Okay.
Are we doing a show this week? Or
we are. We are. I had to go off on a rant.
Yeah. Yeah. You tell me about it.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I get there are things that get me upset. But
you started off that particular conversation by those people that get upset about this shouldn't get upset.
Well, no, it was the things that they get upset about. Plays Kirk.
So they're entitled to get upset then.
Of course. I think they're idiots for doing so.
We'll leave it there, shall we?
I'm
not finished yet. I'm more
the whole say. Well, actually the way the
well,
whole thing started.
All I can say to you is
shut up.
The way the whole thing started was that Star Trek and Star Wars have become so serious that there's no sense of humor anymore. Star Trek has somewhat redeemed itself with Brave New Worlds and definitely with Lower Decks, where they've put some of that humor back in, and that kind of nod and a wink, you know, okay, everybody realize that this isn't real. This is science fiction, and let's just have a good time with it. Whereas you watch something like Andor, Star Wars Andor, and everything is so dark, and it's like, and they put this poor guy through the ringer that's the star of the show.
I'll lighten it up for them.
Somebody should. Same thing with Mandalorian. That needs to be louder. Okay. I'm done. You did that just to get me off my rant, didn't you? Get me off my little pedestal